for the introduction. So yeah, I'll present our paper on revision and conditional inference for abstract dialectical frameworks. So we joint work with Gabriele Kern-Isbanner, Matthias Timm, Tietze Rinstra, and Kenneth Skiba. And so the research question that we answered in this paper is, or started from the observation that in propositional logic, you have this nice triangle of related concepts. So there's well-established ways, I would say, to go from non-monotonic inference to belief revision and back, from conditional logic to non-monotonic inference and back, and from belief revision to conditional logic and back. And so just to give you an example of how this works, if you have a belief revision operator, then you can generate a conditional logic using the Ramsey test. So then you can generate conditionals by checking whether if phi then psi is true by just revising with the antecedent phi, and then checking whether in the revision of the context psi is true. And so there's actually ways to go from one concept to another in all directions. And so the question that we asked in this paper, or we answered in this paper, is whether this triangle can be reproduced for or in argumentative contexts. And so the formal model of argumentative contexts that we used is abstract dialectical frameworks. And abstract dialectical frameworks can be seen as a generalization of Dung's abstract argumentation frameworks. They have in common that an argumentative context is represented as a directed graph, so like the one you can see here. And they also both have in common that nodes in this directed graph represent arguments. The difference, however, is that whereas in Dung's abstract argumentation frameworks, these edges between nodes represent attacks between arguments, in abstract dialectical frameworks, these edges can have any meaning. So for example, you can also represent support, or you can represent attacks of sets of arguments on an argument, and so on. And thus the meaning of these links is then represented by conditions. These conditions are Boolean formulas where every argument has one condition, so one Boolean formula in terms of the links of the parents of the links. So we have a Boolean formula in terms of the edges which are incoming in the argument. And so just to give you an example of how, for example, argumentative attack can be reconstructed in this framework, here we have an attack from B to A, because here the acceptance condition of A is not B. So this intuitively says that A can be accepted if B is not accepted. But we can also model support. For example, here we see that C is supported by A, because we have the acceptance condition if C can be accepted if A is accepted. So all kinds of argumentative relations can be represented in this framework using these acceptance conditions. And the semantics of ADFs are, I would say rather complicated, and I won't go into detail in this talk, but if you have questions, we can talk about it in the poster session. But the semantics are given in terms of three valued interpretations. That's really the important thing here, where every argument is assigned true, false, or undecided. And then the other ingredient of the semantics is the so-called gamma function, which maps three valued interpretations to other three valued interpretations. And then the semantics always select certain fixed points or post-fixed points of this gamma function. For example, the preferred interpretations are the informationally maximal fixed points of this gamma function. So this is a graphical representation. We have the gamma function, which maps three valued interpretations to three valued interpretations. And then the fixed points are of particular interest. So here, this would be the preferred semantics, and this would be the grounded interpretation. That's really all I can say now about the semantics of ADFs. I think what's more interesting for our paper is how we defined AGM revision for ADFs. So the idea is that the type of the revision operator is a revision of an ADF, so of an abstract dialectical framework, by a formula. And the kind of formulas that we considered are an extended language, which is based on propositional logic, but also allows to define undecidedness, for example, because now we are working in a three-valued setting. And so we revise an ADF by a formula resulting in a new ADF. And the underlying logic that we used is cleanest three-valued logic, but you can also use other three-valued logics, so proofs don't really change. So what we did is first to define a set of AGM-like postulates that govern these revisions or tell you what is a rational revision, and then we characterize these revision operator semantically in terms of a total preorder over the three valued interpretations, where one challenge which we had to keep in mind is to ensure the realizability of the selection of three valued interpretations by a chosen semantics. Just to give you a bit more details on what the AGM-like postulates looked like, I'll just walk you through one example. So here the postulate of success, now converted to our setting of revising ADFs by formula, says the following. If we revise an ADF D by the formula Psi, then Psi should hold in all of the interpretations of these revised ADFs, which are selected by the semantics which we have picked or fixed. And the other postulates, I can happily walk you through them in the poster session. So these kind of operators that satisfy these postulates, we also characterize semantically in terms of mappings of ADFs to total preorders over the three-valued interpretation. So the idea is that for every ADF, one generates a total preorder now, not over the two-valued interpretations, as is the case for propositional logic, but over the three-valued interpretations. And there's two conditions that these total preorders have to satisfy. The first is that the minimal interpretations according to this preorder coincide exactly with the interpretation selected by a chosen semantics of the ADF. And the second one is syntax independent. So the idea there is that if two ADFs have the same interpretations according to, or selected by some semantics, then they should also give rise to the same total preorder. And then the connection with revision is the following. The semantics or the interpretation selected by semantics of the revised interpretations can simply be obtained by selecting the minimal interpretations according to this preorder that satisfy the formula by which we revise. So this is a basically generalization of the idea of Katsuno and Mendelssohn when they characterized revision in terms of fateful mappings. However, one challenge, which is also not new, but well known for revision of non-monotonic formalisms, is that we have to make sure that the selection of minimal models, of minimal three-valued interpretations, is actually realizable under the chosen semantics. And so for this, we had to impose additional requirements on these mappings of ADFs to total preorders to ensure that we can actually obtain the proper representation results. And so actually for all of the common semantics for ADFs, we have some requirements on mappings which result in representation results. So that's one edge or one corner of this triangle of related concepts. And so the second concept that we looked at is non-monotonic inference. So we defined non-monotonic inference for three-valued interpretations. The idea is that there is a total preorder over the three-valued interpretations, which represents relative plausibility of the three-valued interpretations. And then we say that if phi, then usually psi holds if and only if the minimal confirming interpretation, so the minimal interpretation that satisfies both the antecedent and the consequent, is strictly more plausible than the minimal falsifying interpretation. So the interpretation that satisfies the antecedent but falsifies the consequent. Again, this is a generalization of the KLM semantics for non-monotonic inference. And it's a rather straightforward generalization to the setting of three-valued interpretations. So here is an example. If you have this plausibility order, we could, for example, see that if B, then usually A, because here the world that confirms both A and B is strictly more plausible than the world which falsifies the inference, so which validates B but falsifies A. And we also generalize the KLM properties for non-monotonic inference to the setting of these three-valued non-monotonic inferences, where really the only adjustment we had to make was rational monotony, where you have to watch out which negation you use, because now there's two kinds to define negation. Yes, and we used here weak negation. And then we could show that these trivalent non-monotonic inferences satisfy actually all of these KLM postulates. So again, if you take some care, you can easily generalize all of the machinery from a propositional setting to a three-valued setting. Then the third concept of this triangle of related concepts that we generalized or took a look at are dynamic conditionals. And so a dynamic conditional holds relative to some semantics and an ADF, if and only if we revise the ADF which we are considering by the antecedent of this dynamical conditional, then the antecedent psi will hold according to the semantics which we are considering. And then we could show that first, these dynamic conditionals can actually be seen as a special case of this trivalent non-monotonic inference properties relations. And secondly, and that's just a corollary of this proposition and the fact that these trivalent non-monotonic inference relations satisfy the KLM properties, that also these dynamic conditionals satisfy all of the KLM properties. And so to conclude, what we did in the paper was to define AGM-like revisions for ADFs based on three-valued logics, and to define and study revision-based conditional reasoning that we could show satisfies the usual KLM postulates. Furthermore, we were able to avoid some pitfalls of a previous approach to revision in ADFs by revising by these formulas in an extended language, which allows to express undecidedness. Furthermore, we also implemented the approach in the Java library of Tweety. So this makes calculating some examples easier. There's also some open work left, of course, for example, to look at other belief change operators in ADFs, such as forgetting, update, or contraction. And we are also investigating the complexity of the approach. Furthermore, I think one can also generalize this concept of a revision-based conditional for other formalisms, such as logic programming or abstract argumentation. So with that, I would like to thank you for your attention, and I hope to see you at the poster session where I can go into more details on this approach.